So therefore, all you people just simultaneously with learning grammar, grammar is important. All you people have to pay attention to it. But apart from not only grammar, don't be expert in grammar, but try to use language for talking, for communication, for discussion, for whatever the activities you people are doing throughout the day. For that purpose, you people need to use language. And see, it is everyday practice. It does not matter that how much you're doing before your placement, how much you're doing in the final year, it does not matter. If you're doing it every day, in that case, you people are going to have expertise. Otherwise, simply, you may be good in grammar, you may be good in listening, you may be good in reading also. But when it comes of your oral communication, that time it is not okay. You're not going to feel confident. You're not going to answer questions. You're not going to participate into group discussions. And so don't let it become your problem, or it should not be a kind of barrier for your career. So all you people just try to think that you people are going to work on communication. Whether you like it or don't like it, that is not the question. If you don't like, even then also you people need to keep talking in English. And whether you like it, even then also you have to take it to next level. And maybe I'm sure that initially you are going to face a lot of problems or difficulties, that you are not able to recollect words, you're not able to make proper sentences, you're not able to use grammar appropriately. But still, you people have to keep going on, because initial mistakes only make you a better speaker. So make mistakes, a lot of mistakes are expected. You have to make such mistakes. You people can begin with your broken English also, so that it is going to become improved and you can have better communication, not only with your teachers. You can imagine that when you people are going to have communication with familiar people. For example, if you are just listening to me, you'll come to know that when you're listening to me, you're quite familiar with me and the way I speak, and so you understand everything that I speak to you. But suddenly, if there is someone first time he is going to talk with you, and when you are just listening them, that time there may be some kind of difficulty you may find, but that is not the difficulty at all. First time it may happen with anybody, that you need to pay more attention and you people have to understand what he is trying to say. Okay, so with this, we people will just try to understand that what you people can do. I think that previously I have shared videos with you also, some videos that I'm sharing with you. So I expect that all you people have to just watch such videos. They are just sample videos. You can find more such videos on YouTube. And all you people just try to communicate, learn, understand, and do whatever. Apart from that, you might be working on your aptitude also. Simultaneously, people work on this also, and technical. So three fronts are there that you people have to take care. First of all, aptitude. Then you people have to develop your verbal ability. Then you people have to develop your communication skills. And then you people focus on your technical knowledge, whatever you may be having, programming, coding, whatever it may be. Your technical knowledge is there. That is important, but that will be at later stage. First of all, aptitude. Because when any company, when any organization, when placement is there, they're not going to ask you simply, let's start with technical knowledge. No. First of all, they will have some aptitude test only. So for that aptitude, you need to be ready with aptitude questions and verbal ability questions. Like reading comprehension is there. That many of the students, they are just having problem with that reading comprehension. Though it is quite simple, but still you could not manage, because their time is short and you cannot read the passage with much time. So therefore, the questions which are asked, they are not always straightforward questions from reading comprehension. So all you people just try to understand that you're practicing it. You practice this reading comprehension also, and synonyms, antonyms also, because these are the important things from the verbal ability point of view. And then you just qualify this aptitude round, then you people will be called for next. It could be a personal interview, and in that personal interview, it is communication which is important. If you are able to communicate, then you people can express whatever you have, knowledge, skills, everything. and then you just focus on your technical skills. If you have technical skills but you are not able to tell, if you are not able to express, then it is of no use to having only technical knowledge. So this way, these three fronts, these three areas, you people try to improve from your side, and then you people just try to work on it. I hope that you people will understand this, it's importance, and you people will work on it. And in between, when you people are just facing any difficulties, any problems, in that case I'm always here that you people have to consult with me, you people have to ask me questions, or whatever the difficulties that you people are getting it, in that case you can just always communicate with me. Okay, fine. So let's go. Apart from that, if anything that is there, you people just add me. In previous session we people have discussed, I think, prepositions we people have done. So here there is exercise, one exercise for you people. You just try to complete that exercise. So I will share the screen and you people just let me know when you people have done it. So on the screen you people will see two passages are there. So read this, it says something like this. You have to choose correct prepositions. So we'll first complete paragraph first. Let me know from division A, is it audible and visible? Division A. And for division B, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. So we'll solve this first exercise first. It says, select correct prepositions to be filled in the given passage from the list given here. So given list of prepositions is that from, to, in, at, around, near, since. And all you people have to read this paragraph and try to fill in these blanks. So you just try to just mark 1, 2, 3, whatever it may be. And when you're done, we'll read that paragraph with correct prepositions. You complete second one also. Similar kind of exercises here. You people have been given prepositions in brackets, since, to, from, through, on, for, and you have given one paragraph, and you people have to complete that paragraph with these prepositions. So remember that not necessarily all prepositions you people have to use. You people just think which preposition suits for these blanks. Okay. Is it okay? Are you going through these paragraphs? You just attempt that. We'll just discuss this after 2 to 3 minutes. And also think that it is not only one preposition. There could be two prepositions can suit it, or there can be one which may not be useful here. Thank you. Have you come with answers? Shall we discuss paragraph one? Okay, so who will read this paragraph? Samruddhi. Samruddhi, you are saying it. Okay, we'll discuss for first paragraph. From division B. Okay, let's continue. So, all of you just pay attention. I hope that this is visible. So small rivers flows dash the heart of Kashi. So if you see that, if you just try to get the options from, to, in, at, around, near, since, flows from the heart of Kashi to the heart of Kashi. Okay, yes. So it is from. So what you will mark here? Small river flows from the heart of Kashi. Okay, so for first blank, you people are going to choose this answer, from the heart of Kashi. And whenever you have doubt or any something, that time you just tell me. So I hope that all are agree with this, that small river flows from the heart of Kashi. Okay, then next people will go to next sentence. From one end to the other of the city there are four bridges dashes. Okay, now you can skip this. Bridges to it, in it, at it, around it, near it, since it. So what do you people can choose here? Around it. Okay, so you are going to mark this. From one end to the other of the city there are four bridges around it. Then next, near the bridge there is a swimming pool where children get training dash May and June. So what will come here? Okay, so in May and June, all you people just try to understand that usually that for the month we people say in January, in February, in May, in June. So children get training in May and June. Then next, the new trainees are generally seen practicing dash the river bank. Yes, Mrunal, you're getting it right, that near the river bank. Okay, so the new trainees are generally seen practicing near the river bank. Exactly. Then they are not allowed to go dash a certain point. Yes, it is to a certain point. They are not allowed to go to a certain point. And then beside the bridge, there are small boats anchored and one can enjoy boating. That's a very nominal payment. Yes, at a very nominal payment. So all you people just try to be clear with this and read once again. Small rivers flows from the heart of Kashi, from one end to the other of the city. There are four bridges around it. Near the bridge, there is a swimming pool where children get training in May and June. The new trainees are generally seen practicing near the river bank. They are not allowed to go to a certain point. Beside the bridge, there are small boats anchored and one can enjoy boating at a very nominal payment. That is about paragraph 1. Is it clear to everyone from division A? Okay, for division B, any?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Then we'll go to next paragraph. Okay, so now I think that again here Samruddhi has sent me answers. Okay, all right. So you people tell me, say, Mr. Srivastav received a letter - his daughter. So what do you choose? Since, to, from, through, on, back, for?
From.
Yes, all you people are right. Those who are thinking and telling me from. So from is correct. Blank here. Mr. Srivastav received a letter from his daughter who had been living in Chennai - many years. Yes, all you people are right. Who had been living in Chennai since many years. Okay, now she was coming home - air from Chennai.
True.
Is it through air or on air? You just try to be sure. What is it? Through air. Yes. Then everybody except Mrs. Srivastava was standing outside - receive their daughter.
Two.
Yes. To receive their daughter. The girl had brought many presents -
For.
Yes, for. The girl had brought many presents for her brother, mother and father. The family kept - chatting. What will come?
On.
Yes, all right. The family kept on chatting till midnight and went to bed very late. So once again, I'll read this paragraph with all the blanks. Mr. Srivastav received a letter from his daughter who had been living in Chennai since many years. Now she was coming home through air from Chennai. Everybody except Mrs. Srivastava was standing outside to receive their daughter. The girl had brought many presents for her brother, mother and father. The family kept on chatting till midnight and went to bed very late. Okay, so that is what just exercise related to this prepositions. So additionally, you people are going to get, I will share another screen and we'll have another discussion. Okay, fine. I hope the screen is visible. White screen is visible. And here, now we are going to discuss this common errors in use of preposition. Is the font visible? Here I'm going to give some sentences. All you people have to just find out what can be error there. Then second one is that the next two people are going to see then next one. Then fifth one is here. Then we have next one. All you people try to understand that you people have to think about preposition. We are talking about what errors can be there, and you people are going to find it out. If you're coming, you just tell me. If you are just able to find it out, you just tell me. Okay, first of all, we discuss these 9 errors here, and my brother. Okay, first sentence. First of all, my brother resembles to me. So, what you are going to choose? Here, which is
resembles me.
Okay, so what you are going to do? You are going to omit this preposition. There is no need to say my brother resembles to me. Resembles means looking same. Okay, so my brother resembles me means the same meaning. You need not to use to. My brother resembles me. Then second word is for resembles for me. Do you mean like to? This
no, so second one.
Yes, here for. So what is the use of for here? How you are going to correct it? He has ordered for dinner. You are going to say he has ordered dinner. No need to use for. Then here also you people are going to think about he reached Pune. Oh yes, you are going to omit here. You are going to skip this. He reached Pune simply. No need to use. He reached at Pune. The next, the teacher entered into the classroom.
Into.
Yes, you are going to remove this. The teacher entered the classroom. Simply, this is correct one. The teacher entered the classroom. Okay. Then next is, he picked up a quarrel with him. So what you are going to skip here? He picked up a quarrel with him. Okay. Then next, let us discuss about the problem.
About.
So what you are going, how you are going to use it correctly? Let us discuss the problem, not about the problem. Okay, let's discuss the problem. Then may I accompany with you? May I accompany you? Simply that means, should I come with you? Something like this. He approached to his office. In this case, simply you are going to correct it by calling, he approached his office. No need to use to. And last one, I requested to him. So in this case, how, what will be correct one?
I requested him
will be correct you. So here you people just try to use, sometimes we people use unnecessarily such kind of prepositions that people have to avoid, like these examples. Okay. Then we people will just have some exercise here, and you people have to tell me again answers now. So you have to choose the correct prepositions for like this. First of all, the sentences. He lived dash rather dash. So what will the correct answers here? What will write it down? Yes, Ganesh. He lived from Dadar to Mumbai. I think that I need to provide options also. Whether it is in, then in case of B, you just try to think whether it is at and at. Then in case of next one, you people just try to think whether it is in and at, or you just try to choose whether it is at and in. Now tell me. It cannot be from the other to Mumbai. How you can live like this?
At the other in Mumbai.
At the other in Mumbai. Option B, at or at the other in Mumbai. So here you people have to remember, when it comes like this, so that time you people have to think for smaller area like Dadar. Dadar is a small area in Mumbai. So for that, people have to choose at. And for bigger areas, you people are going to choose in. So what is going to be correct option here in this case? He lived at Dadar in Mumbai. That is going to be correct answer for this question. So all you people just try to be clear with this. Then we'll have another kind of question. And can you come with without options?
Off.
Yes. So here you are going to say off. She is proud of her beauty. It should not be something like that, other thinking. Then next is, what will you choose here?
Off.
By, from, in. These are options. With, by, from, in. Okay. Now choose.
With.
Whether it is with pencil or by pencil. I think that in chat box you people are sending me, I'm not able to see chats. Okay, so for this he's writing with a pencil and not by. You people just try to understand. Then next is and your options are like this. Then next two people have two. Then next is off or off.
Four.
Yes. Here also people are right that if people have to choose, he is qualified for that post. Next is and your options for this on, upon, over, or at. So what do you choose? On the bridge was on the river. On the river. In division B, I'm not able to say anything. You people just unmute and speak.
On the
river. See, when we say the book is on the table. So suppose this is surface. So for such things, when there is a book, you people have to read something like this. So it is touches to the surface. So in this case, if you're going to say on the river, with division B, you just wait for 2 minutes, maybe people will come back. Division A got disconnected from Zoom, so we'll start within 2 minutes. Okay, all right. So before going ahead, we'll just finish this exercise and we'll take attendance and then we'll go for next part, that is conjunction. Okay. Yes, Shubham, you can ask.
Yes, sir.
So before a while, you told there was I did not remember the whole sentence, but there was a two words. Many years there, you told that there you used a for since preposition. According to me, that is wrong. When there is not accurate time, then how should we use there a since preposition? Since preposition, there is accurate time. In that time, you can use a since preposition. There is a many years, so we should use there a for preposition.
Okay, so you mean to in first exercise passages?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, I will share that screen again and we'll discuss that. All right, so all of you just pay attention that here is one question, query we'll call it, from Shubham, and we'll all discuss this. So let's share, I will share that screen and we'll solve it. Okay, so here the Shubham has problem with this. So his daughter had been living in Chennai since many years, so for many years. So here you people can just think, when we people use since, that shows a particular time. Okay, for example, since 2011 or something like this,
as well as particular date, particular name, and a particular year.
Okay, and in case of for, we people use a period of time, for 10 years, for 2 years, for maybe let's say we'll take here 5 years. Okay, so this is the correct way of using since and for. Or rather, I will explain it with three concepts are here. First of all, we'll talk about from and to. Then there is since, and then there is for. So all those three prepositions, they refer to time. Okay. So in first case, it is from to. For example, from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. something like that. In this case, what happened that in case of from and to, the beginning of the time is given and closing or ending time is also given. So in that case, we people can use from to, from January to December, from this to that, from 8 to 10, from Monday to Friday. So this time, beginning is also given and the ending is also given. In case of since, I have told you, it gives the when a particular activity started. So usually it is beginning. So since that, since morning, since, but closing we don't know. We just know only beginning, we don't have closing. So beginning, something like that, since 2001, since a particular time is given, as Shubham rightly said, that is beginning. And then here it is for. In this for, it is period is given, time period. Okay, so for 1 day, for 1 year, for 1 month, for something like this. So in this case, all you people now need to think about that, what you people just wanted to be take here like this. It is many years now. So if you consider this, it is not anything like beginning and ending. No, we cannot have that beginning and ending here. Then we people can think here about any particular beginning. Here is no any beginning is given. It is many years, and so what left, that is since. Okay, so all you people have to mark for. This is answer. Living in Chennai for many years. Those who are just already, we people have discussed this answer since, but instead of since, we people can take here for. Is it clear for everyone? And thank you, Shubham, for just coming with this question. From division A, is it clear? Or in you have another questions, difficulties, queries here? It is going to be for many years. From division A, there is no response. Okay. From division B, I hope that all you people might be clear. And Shubham, I think you are also clear.
Yes, sir.
Okay, alright. So we'll go back. I will stop sharing this screen and we'll go back to what we people are discussing. There was one question that I have given you people. The bridge was dash the river. And you people were having options like this, whether it is on the river, whether it is upon the river, whether it is at the river, or whether it is over.
Over.
So earlier we people were just, I was talking about why it is not on, because all you people have to understand, when we say on, it shows on the surface, on the table. The book is on the table at that time. This is surface of table and the book is here. In such cases, you people can use on, but you cannot use on here because the bridge was not on the surface of the river. So it is over the river. So this you people just try to understand. Then another question I will just try to give people. The question is that he is good dash English but poor dash maths, and very people get options like this. At in, then you have at, then you have in at, and then you have in. So what you'll choose and tell me correct is good dash English, option A. Is it, are you sure? Option A. So only people just try to understand, when we people talk about such things where you people are asked something like this, so when there is good, so good means that you people are talking about the strength or something that is good, so that time you people have to show it with at. He's good at English. And when it is the poor does not mean economically, it means that you are not good in mathematics, so in that case you people have to use in. Okay, so he is good at English but poor in maths. So this will be the correct way. Okay, all right. So that's all about exercise, because I could not get another kind of typical exercise, or maybe if I get time, I will just prepare another exercise for this also. And today I'm just planning to complete everything from parts of speech. So we'll just complete conjunctions today, and we'll have test on this first unit. Parts of speech, noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection, everything. Okay, so we'll take attendance and then we'll complete conjunctions. Samruddhi, I hope that you got it. It is at an end. So first of all, I will take attendance of division A. So So for that, all you people just rename yourself in one common format. I don't know who is joining with this name Anil Sawant. I don't see any name Anil Sawant in our division. Division A, Anil Sawant, who is? Rename yourself. And a common format, if you are just following, all you people will rename like this. ENTC capital, then underscore, then SY. Oh, no, you are just, why you are making that much complicated? Okay, you make it simple, all of you. All you people, just if you're just maintaining this kind of format, it should be like this. All you people, just I'll send you into chat box. Division A, ENTC. Then you people use underscore. Then you people use SYA. Then underscore. And then your roll number. What is it? Maybe 010. All you people rename in this way. So it makes me easy to mark attendance. Okay, so all of you just rename like this immediately. Sureka Puri, don't use space after ENTC, only underscore is there, no space. Then SYA, then only underscore, there is no space, and then there is roll number 1. So this way all of you just rename immediately, rename so that we can take attendance. Sureka Puri, Vaishnavi Lokande, Omkar, then Pratik A58, Prerna Puri, Tukaram, everybody. Immediately, all you if you follow this, then all you people will come with sequence from 1 to whatever 66. Ruturaj, everybody. Immediately, you rename yourself. I want roll number 1 in the beginning. So don't give any space. Rushali, don't give space. Ganesh Sagar, don't give any space. It should be simply NTC, only underscore. Then SYA, only underscore, no space. And then 2-digit roll number. So those who are like Maheshwari, Mrunal, Vaishnavi, Megha, Sureka, Tukaram, Prerna, Pratik, Vaishnavi Lokande, Ganesh Sagar, and Urshali. All you people have to rename yourself. Snehal. Snehal, you just try to see SYA, not SY underscore A. Snehal, come there. Megha Mohite, Sureka Puri, Tukaram, Prerna, Pratik, Vaishnavi, Rushali. Rushali, don't give space after ENTC. All you people see the chat box. ENTC underscore SYA underscore, then 2-digit roll number. And there are some students who have been joining with old division roll numbers also. So all of you are requested. So it will save time. Otherwise, I have to spend a lot of time for attendance. So first of all, division A, all you people. J can see 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 13, 17, 62 62 64 66 10 31 38 44 60 65. So all of you just confirm absent numbers from division A, roll number 3 absent, and 12, 14, 15, 16, 25, 28, 30, 32, 39, 40, 41, 43, 45, 49, 51, 52, 55, 56, 57, 59, 63. If anybody is present out of these roll numbers, you just let me know that you are here. And also take care that your attendance, you are just having proper roll numbers, because afterwards some students call me and then say, sir, I was present in the class, I have given attendance, my roll number was different, I joined late, there was network issue. After this attendance, nobody will be entertained. So are you clear with your attendance, Division A? Okay, all right. So with this, we'll move towards the now attendance of Division B. So the students from Division B, I hope that all you people might have. Again, Division B, you are not following the common pattern. Here I can see 65 roll number Kedar Patil in the beginning. How it comes? Then 35, then 50. How to mark your attendance? So similar pattern for you people also, ENTC underscore, SYB underscore, and then 01, like Pragati has done, roll number 1, Pragati. All you people just follow that common pattern. Alright, so I will mark attendance in Division B. You can see 35, then 50, then 21, 32. Then 62, 1, 5, 13, 16, 18, 22, 23, 28, 29, 33, 36, then 37, 43, 45, 46, then 52, 54, then 68, 4, 2, 3, 7, 8, 10. These are present students from Division B. 11, 12 is also there. 14, 15. 17, 20. 26, 27. 30. 31, 38. Then 40, 42, And Urshali Guru.
Yes, sir.
You don't have mentioned any roll number in your name. So what is your roll number?
Sir, B06.
Okay, so absent numbers from division B are 9, 19, 24, 25, 44, 47, 49, 61, 64, 65, 67.
65, sir, present.
Who is 65?
Sir, 19, present.
Who is 19?
No reply, nothing.
Sir, 65, present.
65, okay. All right, so with this, we people have done with attendance, but be connected with us, because I'm sure that many of the students may leave this meeting because they just, some students are especially for attendance only, so we are not bothered with that also. But ensure that you people are learning something. Okay, we are going back and we are going to discuss some conjunctions here. Is it visible? The screen is visible to all people?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. All right. So first of all, we'll just try to understand what is conjunction. So conjunction is part of speech that is used to connect words, phrases, clauses, or sentences. So very important that we can connect two words also. For example, Ram and Shyam. Here, two words are connected that you people have to understand. Then we people can connect two phrases also. For example, come and go, something like this. Then clauses and sentences that you people are going to see through examples. So conjunctions are considered to be invariable grammar particle, and they may or may not stand between items they conjoin. So what do you mean by this? So many of the times where conjunctions are used, but sometimes that you people have one particular conjunctions that people use, and sometimes there are some words in between, like neither nor either or something like this. So in that case, something is coming in between that, and so therefore it is said may or may not stand between. So for example, given here, he gave them no money, nor did he help them in any way. So here the conjunction that people will see, that is not, and it is connecting two clauses, we'll call it. He gave them no money, this is one, and did he help them in any way, that is another clause. Okay, and in following slides we people will see another types of conjunctions, and these two types are coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. So in case of coordinating conjunctions, what do you mean by coordinating conjunctions? When the sentences, two sentences or two words, when they are just having independent two sentences, independent two clauses, so that when they're connected with the conjunction, that conjunction is called coordinating conjunctions. Ashi vakya, ji don arthacha drushtine swatantra vakya astat, ashi vakya jyavis ja conjunction ni jodli jatat, tala apan coordinating conjunctions asa mhanto. You'll come to know that here, for, and, nor, but, or, and. So these are called coordinating conjunctions. You will come to know for can be also replaced with because, and means in addition to whatever earlier said or told. norm is not, but is similar to however, or can be similar to either. It is also again similar for but, and so means therefore. So the some exercise that you people are going to solve, it may be just coming like this, that you people have to choose appropriate conjunction. So in that case, it can be so, it can be therefore. So they are similar, and you people can read through examples also, which is given here. It says, first of all, I have to find a new job, for I am unemployed. So what you can replace here, you can replace the same sentence with because also. I have to find a new job because I'm unemployed. So you people can think like this. But here, this is coordinating conjunction. So you can write two separate sentences. I have to find a new job, this is one sentence. I am unemployed, this is another sentence. But if you're using it with because, that becomes dependent. I have to find a new job, and that, if you are joining it with because, that time it becomes subordinating conjunction. So because is subordinating conjunction, but for is coordinating conjunctions. Okay, I hope that you are understanding. Pratheka?
Yes, sir.
Please calm down. Let's wait and see. So for and, you people can get number of examples. Neither my parents nor my friends supported me. In fact, it is not only nor, we usually call it a compound conjunction, that is neither nor, or you can call it neither nor also. So neither my parents nor my friends supported me. Very important use of verb. Okay. So when you people are going to use verb after neither nor, you people have to use according to this subject. Okay. If it is like that, I will give another example. This is sentence, and you people have to tell me which verb will be correct one. Was or were. Neither students nor teacher was present or were present. You have to choose one. You cannot use was or were together. I have given as oblique, so you have to choose one. And what that will be. Awaaz aata hai na? Division B, is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I just told you that you people have to use the verb according to the subject, which is, or the noun, which is coming after nor. So what is here? Teacher. So to consider teacher, is it singular or plural? Teacher?
Singular.
Singular. So what you'll use? Was or were?
Was.
So correct sentence will be like this. You'll read like this. Neither students nor teacher was present. So that way you people are going to read it. Remember, though it is students, but you are not going to take were, because you are going to use verb as per the noun or the subject which is coming after nor. All right, is it clear, Kalaka? If it is vice versa, if it is singular here and plural here, then you people are going to use where. If it is teachers, you are going to use where. Okay, so you need not think what is here, it is singular, plural, whatever it may be, but whatever the verb you are going to choose, you are going to choose after this verb. Then next, but I have got a home, but I haven't got a car. So in this case also, you people have to consider, this is coordinating conjunctions that you people have to understand, that both sentences you people can write independently. If you are going to separate it, you can write it separately. but if you just need to use or if you if these two sentences are depending upon each other for meaning, in that case they become subordinating conjunctions. Here is or does Clark have any brothers or sisters? You can ask Clark have either brothers or sisters, something like this. At and but are similar. He says nice words, yet you don't trust him. You can use but also. He says nice words, but you don't trust him. So therefore, similar, you can replace each other. My daughter is very smart, so everybody likes her. Or you can say, my daughter is very smart, therefore everybody likes her. There is difference, but you can use similar. Then we people have subordinating conjunctions, which can be used for comparison, like this, than, rather than, whether, as much as, whereas. Then you people can think after, as soon as, which are referring to time, until, whenever, now, that. Though, although, even though, all are similar, you people can use it. It can be replaced again for with but also. So you people just try to understand that though. I'll give one example here. So this is same one sentence. Though he is rich, he leads a simple life. So you can replace with but also. He is rich, but he leads a simple life, something like this. Then next, relative pronouns that we people have already discussed while talking, learning about pronouns we people have studied here, like this. Who, whoever, whom, whomever, whose, like this. People can just try to understand who, who's, something like this. For reason, you people have this because, since, so that, in order to, add, something like this. For condition, you people can get if, only if, unless, provided that, assuming that, something like this. Then for place, where, wherever, relative adjectives like that. Whatever, which, whichever. So they are similar. Relative pronouns and these, they can be. So they refer to person, they refer to place or object. And for manner, people can have how, as though, as if. So we are not going to discuss much about these conjunctions. We are going to discuss few examples, few exercises that people can consider, that you people have to choose. And then we people will stop here today. Okay, so I will share another screen. I'll stop sharing this screen. Okay, all right. Once again, here in this PDF, you people can read more about conjunctions that people would like to talk. So, conjunctions are the words that join two words, phrases, two clauses. There are two types of conjunctions, coordinating conjunctions. They are used to join two or more words, phrases, or two main or independent clauses, of the equal rank. That is what I explained. The two separate sentences which are independent. Okay, that is important. The common coordinating conjunctions are and, or, but, not, so, therefore, at. So you can see here example. He is poor, but he is an honest person. So your but is coordinating conjunction. In this sentence, but joins two principal clauses. That is, he is poor is a main clause. He is an honest person. That is also equally similar main clause, and that is joined with but. And here you people can read other examples as well. My friend enjoys poetry and fiction as well. So again, you'll come to know that you people can see and is coordinating conjunctions. The next is or. We must work hard or face the failure. So or is conjunction here, coordinating conjunction here. My father invited them, but they didn't come. Okay. I know you must be tired, so I will let you rest. So it's here. I felt lonely, therefore I went to play cricket with my friends. Christmas was only a few days away, yet it didn't seem like Christmas. So these are few examples that you people can understand, try to understand from these examples. So now people will just go to exercise. All the people have to answer me that what you people have been understood from this. So first sentence, you people have been given some conjunctions in bracket like and, or, but, so, nor, yet, still, and therefore. So first sentence is, it was raining heavily, dash, we cancelled our trip to Goa.
So
what about other people? What do you think? Can you think of this also? Will it be suitable? It was raining heavily, so we cancelled our trip to Goa. Okay. And if you think with this, it was raining heavily, therefore we cancelled our trip to Goa. Will it be okay?
Yes, sir.
So in this case, you people have to understand that both things will be okay. It is not only one answer is going to be right. You can say both are correct. Okay. Because sometimes multiple answers are possible, multiple conjunctions are possible. So in this case, both are correct. It was raining heavily, so we cancel our trip to Goa. It was raining heavily, therefore we cancel our trip to Goa. Then you can think about second one, teachers and dash parent. Okay. Teachers dash parents save the lives of children.
And
I think that students from division A, they got disconnected from Zoom. So we'll start soon. So you just stay connected. We'll be back within 2 minutes only. Yes, all right. So students are joining, and Samruti, you're right. That is and. All you people can understand that this is and. Students can join. Meanwhile, we'll just continue. Okay, all right, then you people are going to move towards the next question. C. Walking is a very good exercise, dash, many people don't go for it.
But.
Okay, but. Any other? Is it only but?
Yes.
Yes. So, 8. because you people are telling me, but I cannot see from division B. I cannot see who is speaking, so I cannot take your names, because that's when I share the screen from Google Meet. At the time, I don't have the participants and their messages in front of me. So those who are telling me answers, that you people are right. In division A, I can see who is talking and who is chatting with me. So you people just be active. Division A and Division B, both of you just unmute and speak. That will be okay for me. So you can use both. Walking is a very good exercise, but many people don't go for it. Or you can say walking is a very good exercise, yet many people don't go for it. Then next, we people have sentence. This sentence: you can eat your cake with a spoon dash a fork.
Or.
So people. Yes, you're right. Or you'll be correct. Then his two favorite sports are football dash tennis.
And.
Yes. All people write that football and tennis will be quite right to pay. Then next F. I wanted to go to the beach. Mary refused.
But.
I wanted to go to the beach, but Mary refused. So you're going to choose this. Then next sentence G is here. She is a vegetarian dash. She doesn't eat any meat.
Therefore.
So.
This time also people are going to write down both of them. Those who said so is right. Those who said therefore, that is also right. So try to understand. She is a vegetarian, so she doesn't eat any meat. She is a vegetarian, therefore she doesn't eat any meat. Then next we have H. Jennifer doesn't like to swim dash she enjoys cycling.
But therefore.
This time also you people can think for multiple answers. So you can choose therefore, you can choose so, you can choose but also. Jennifer doesn't like to swim, but she enjoys cycling. Jennifer doesn't like to swim, so she enjoys cycling. Jennifer doesn't like to swim, therefore she enjoys cycling. Three people can make meaning by these three conjunctions, using these three conjunctions also. Then next we people have sentence I. It says, the students didn't submit the assignments dash did they consult the teacher? I think that
no,
somebody raised a hand. Was Aisha? Was it you from division? Somebody raised a hand. If you have a question, feel free to ask. We are going to discuss it. From division A, Aisha, I think that was it. Aisha, I don't know who, but somebody raised a hand. If you don't have, by mistake, it's okay. We'll just go back and we'll just try to discuss this. Somebody said not. Okay, nor is going to be correct answer. The students didn't submit the assignments, nor did they consult the teacher. Okay, so no. And here is the last one, J sentence. It is a small car. It is surprisingly spacious. Ronald.
But yet.
Yes, both are similar. You people can use both. You can say it is a small car. Yet it is surprisingly spacious. You can say it is a small car, but it is surprisingly spacious. So you people need to understand when it is but, usually there is contrast. What is contrast? So a small car and spacious. So this contrast everywhere when your people are going to get any sentence from but, you'll see the contrast like this. He's clever but lazy. So you'll come to know clever and lazy, that can be contrast. So still it is small car, still it is surprisingly spacious. Yes, still can be used. Again, Samruddhi, you people are coming with new options. It is small car, still it is surprisingly spacious. That also people can use. So are you clear with this exercise? Should we go to subordinating conjunctions and its exercise? So let's try to understand some subordinating conjunctions. So subordinating conjunctions, they are used to join one main clause and one or more subordinate clause. So that is the difference between coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. In coordinating conjunctions, both are main clause, they are equal rank. But in subordinating conjunctions, there is one main clause and there are one or more subordinate clause or clauses. They introduce a dependent clause and describe the relationship between dependent clause and independent clause. So these are the conjunctions. They join these main clause and subordinate clause, but they also explain what is the relationship between them also. The common subordinating conjunctions are like unless, after, till, since, if, before, than, that, though, although, where, when, while, because, as soon as, until. You can see example here. If you pay the bill, I will be very happy. So there is a kind of condition. Okay, how they are dependent? I will be happy. If it is only I will be happy, and you may not get the sense. I will be happy simply. If you pay the bill, if you just taking these two sentences, there is condition, and that makes a sense that if you pay the bill, I will be very happy. Okay, so here if it's subordinate conjunctions which introduce subordinate clause, you pay the bill, that is subordinate clause. Main clause is I will be happy. And here you people can read other examples. I won't pay unless you provide the goods immediately. Okay, so similar kind of condition. The next, he will not see me till it comes very near. So till. He had been in a grumpy mood since he got up. Then next is if you come late, I will punish you. Next, let's go to the course last time before we leave. Then we should not spend more than we earn. I think that I know who sang this song. I think that I know who sang this song. Next, she spoke quietly because she didn't want Ramesh to hear. Then we people have next. As soon as I hear any news, I will call you. I definitely meet him whenever I go to Paris. Companies are training their employees so that they can use their talents efficiently. Harry is the best friend of mine, though we don't see each other very often. Even though he is a millionaire, he lives in a very small flat. No one left the room until the talk ended. Although he is very famous, still he is humble. You'll come, you know, here is although is there, and here is still is also there. But here still is subordinating conjunction. The next is when you are in London, write an email to me. So these were the given examples, and now here we people have exercise that we people have to solve. In bracket, you people have been given unless, if, when, because, as if, although, after, before, as soon as. And we people have sentence A. The train had already departed - I reached the station. And you people tell me answer.
Before.
Before. before. Okay, all you people have to ensure the train had already departed before I reached the station. So what you are going to choose? This one. The next, Sachin scored more getting tips from his coach.
After.
Yes, Mrunal. After. After getting tips from his coach. So you'll choose after here. Yes, all you people are right. Prerna, Abhishek, and everyone. The next we have seen, I shall contact him dash he comes back.
As soon as
he comes back, you can choose when also. I shall contact him when he comes back. So that can be, and this can be. You people can choose. Then next we have sentence D. You will not get success. You work hard.
Unless.
Yes. You will not get success unless you work hard. Then you people have sentence E. It says Seema didn't come to college. She was out of station.
Because,
you're right. Seema didn't come to college because she was out of station. The next, Ashok will get the job dash he deserves it.
If
he deserves it. Okay. Next is G. He was behaving in such a way. He was a king.
As if.
Yes. This time people have to choose this. As if. Jasakai to Raja Sahas. He was behaving in such a way as if he was a king. Next. Dash he got enough time, he could not complete his assignment within time.
Although.
Ronald. It will be although he got enough time, he could not complete his assignment within time. If will be irrelevant. You cannot use if here. Next, you should finish your homework dash I get back to home.
Before
I get back to home. Yes. So that was about the exercise based on this subordinating conjunctions. And now you people will see here correlative conjunctions also. What is this correlative conjunctions are here? They're called, we can call it compound conjunctions also like this. So let's try to understand more about these correlative conjunctions and we'll stop here today. They're used in pairs to connect two words, phrases, or clauses that carry equal importance within a sentence. The common correlative conjunctions are either or, either or neither nor, neither nor, not only but also, as, rather than, both and, if then, whether or, so these are correlative conjunctions. Okay, so they are using pairs. If people can read these examples, you should go either by bus or by train. Neither the police officers nor the military personnel were present there. The car is not only economical, but also easy to drive. I like you as much as he does. If you promise, then I will come. She is free to decide whether to play or not. Okay. So now all you people just be alert and solve these exercise. So first of all, we people are going to talk about this one. You people have been given either or, neither nor, not only but also as a if then, whether or. Next, first one. Dash my parents allow, dash I will decide to come with you.
If then.
Yes, you people are right. You people are going to choose if then. How it is going to be read? If my parents allow, then I will decide to come with you. Okay, so if then. The next, number two, Dr. Kalam was dash a scientist and author of many famous books.
Not only but also.
Yes, Dr. Kalam was not only a scientist but also an author of many famous books. The next, number C, the management will decide dash to install this machine dash not.
Whether or.
Yes, you people can use whether to install this machine or not. You people can use either or also. Either to decide this machine, either to install this machine or not. Then next, number D, all you people have to be very alert for this question. Ritu is a dash tall, intelligent than Deepa.
Not only by person.
It is as, not only as. So it is going to be not only but also. Ritu is not only tall but also intelligent than Deepa. Okay? You cannot choose as. As tall as, no. Then we people have sentence E. Dash, you finish your work, leave your job.
Whether or.
We cannot use whether or here. You people can think of this.
Either or.
Yes, either or. Either you finish your work or leave the job. Okay, that will be okay. Then next, number F. Your company offers dash a good salary dash an opportunity to grow.
Not only but also.
Yes, you can use your company offers not only a good salary but also an opportunity to grow, and you can think of this also. Can you use neither nor? Yes, you people can use. You can say your company offers neither a good salary nor an opportunity to grow. Okay, even that is also possible. Okay, all right, so that's all for today, and I hope that all you people might have just doing good. So don't just be dependent on grammar only, but think that what you people can do for English communication. Do usually talk with your friends, make groups in the evening. You people can share some of the your thoughts and ideas based on that, whatever you people have studied, your methods of study, what you people have learned, and number of activities that you people have been doing, that all things you people can share with each other by having a kind of group discussion that you people can think, or also a number of things that you people can do for improve your communication, because it is the atmosphere that you people have been creating that is going to matter. You may be simply learning, studying, but independent study is not going to help you for improving your communication. So I request all of you people that all you people should try to improve it, work on it. You people just try to listen that how you can take yourself to next level communication, because even I cannot help you people to improve your oral communication. I may just help you for grammar, I may help you for what to do, what not to do, but as far as your oral communication is there, you people are own responsible for that. So take care and you just grow. So with that, should we stop here? Should I end this meeting for all of you for division A? Should I end this?
Yes.
Okay, all right. Thank you for joining today. For division B, should I close this call?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right.